story. They have a character to them. No. The contemporary home really has the power in its simplicity to become a fantastic gallery. In other words, again, the house itself steps back, provides an open space and a clean space, not unlike you would expect as you walk in through an art gallery or a museum, the structure itself. And what does it do? Inside the home, the artwork on the wall, the furniture in the room, the possessions, the belongings, and so on. Nothing does a better job than a contemporary home. This gallery. Also, they are highly energy efficient, and their architecture allows them, again, when done right, to form, to rise, to blend, to belong to the area around it, not to make all the mistakes of boxy, clunky, weird, angular, sterile, institutional. No, they can really ascend. They really, truly can. They are going to be filled with state-of-the-art appliances, state-of-the-art technology. They're going to be warm. They're going to be cool. They're going to be green wherever possible, meaning that it's the nature of contemporary building techniques to be as sustainable and green and environmentally non-impactful as possible. And they don't have to be cold and impersonal. The best of contemporary homes are clad in organic contrast. You may have a wall of glass surrounded by a kind of wood siding or cladding next to it that is beautiful, non-painted, fully exposed wood grain. There's lots and lots of opportunities within contemporary design to make a house really, really special. And because it doesn't have a historical story that it's trying to overwrite, you've really got, in my opinion, the freedom to write your own story onto this house. And that brings me to maybe the culmination point that I'm trying to make this morning, or answering the question, can a contemporary home have a soul? Of course it can have a soul. In many ways, now this is my opinion, but you know, I want you to listen and consider it. In many ways, a contemporary home, contemporary architecture, is maybe the most honest architecture. And what do I mean by that? I mean, it doesn't embrace a fantasy of a particular point in time, but it accepts the present, the now, okay? So when I mean honest, I mean, you know, a Victorian home is lovely. I mean, it is lovely. But guess what? Victorianism, that was like 130 years ago, okay? We aren't living in that time anymore. But people who live in those homes kind of are in their own heads living in that time. That's a fantasy, though, isn't it? A contemporary home doesn't have that baggage, as it were, attached to a traditional motif. It's a very honest home. It's basically saying, hey, guess what? I was built in 2021, and you're living in 2021. This is the world as it is now. This is where we are. This is where we're going. This is now. And to do now right, I know a lot of people, you know, run to the past. A lot of people get trapped in the past. But to do now right is really to just kind of, you know, live in the present moment. So like any home, a contemporary home can become a repository of all things us. It can be a repository of our 21st century lives, our 21st century stories, and our unique 21st century way of doing things. So you're never going to find in me a bias against a particular kind of architecture. And so what I wanted to do this morning is just have a little bit more conversation about these contemporary homes to see their value, to see their potential. Yeah, there's a lot of crap out there. Yes. So, you know, that's just another Tuesday in Southern California. But when they're done right, wow. I mean, they can be, wow. They really are. And there's something soulish about being honest about where we're at and where we're going. And there you go. That's my opinion on it. All right. When we come back, let's talk to you. Let's talk about your home a little bit more. We will go to the phones. But first, Brian Berumen has it. Local environmentalists have joined people who live in Porter Ranch to mark the 6th anniversary of the 2015 Aliso Canyon gas leak.
Hooted Water Watch's Alexandra Nagy says she comforted many people during the leak.
Mothers who lost their children or parents, people who lost their pets, and children who lost their fathers. This heartbreak continues today.
She is among the group who is calling on Governor Newsom to shut the facility down within a year. The group is also pushing the California Public Utilities Commission to vote no on two proposals next month that would increase gas storage at the site. The gas leak in 2015 was the largest in U.S. history. Blake Trolley, KFI News.
News brought to you by Ducky Power Services. The 101 freeway east of downtown L.A. is closed for 2.5 miles for a project to replace the 6th Street Viaduct. The closure between the 10 freeway on the south and the 510-101 freeway interchange at the north began last night and will continue until 3 p.m. tomorrow. The area will be closed again November 4th through November 6th. The work is part of the city's $588 million 6th Street Viaduct replacement project to replace a 1930s-era structure that's considered unsafe in an earthquake. Homicide detectives with the L.A. County Sheriff's Department say they're hoping a $15,000 reward will help find the killer of the 23-year-old man from La Puente. Lieutenant Charles Calderero says Christopher Perez was not affiliated with the gang.
On December 11th, 2020, here at this park, just outside the restroom, Christopher was confronted by unknown individuals and was shot and killed during what we believe was a commission of a robbery.
Calderero says he believes the reward will compel witnesses to come forward or maybe get people to talk about the incident. There's a crash on the 91.
Stay at Vincent Redux, 91 eastbound just before Bloomfield, carpool at two left lanes. Blocked by the crash, it's actually jammed back to Pioneer Boulevard. You heard Brian mention that closure downtown on the 101 freeway. Both sides are shut down between the 5 and the 10 currently. Your best alternative is going to be the 5 or the 110 freeway instead. And Caltrans working in Pacoima as well on the eastbound side of the 210 freeway between 118 and Wheatland. It's three right lanes shut down until around 9 o'clock this morning. Heavy delays through the area there. KFI in the sky helps get there faster. I'm Robert Lucky.
So you're ready to build your new dream kitchen. Good for you. What's your first move? I think it should be a totally free in-showroom consult at the kitchen store. Because you're going to get two things that you desperately need right out of the gate. You're going to get the creativity and the wisdom of an expert kitchen designer. That's number one. And while you are getting that from your designer, you're going to be flooded with inspiration and information in the kitchen store's 7,000 square foot cabinet design showroom. That's number two. Kitchen store's right off the 405 in Culver City. For more than 50 years, it's been the best place for kitchen cabinets in all of Southern California. They have state-of-the-art computer design, famous cash financing, no payments, no interest for a full year, and pricing that will beat the big box store. So, start a new kitchen right. Set up your free consult today by dialing 310-KITCHEN. That's 310-KITCHEN. And check out the kitchen store on the web at 310kitchen.com. Southland weather from KFI, partly cloudy by this afternoon, mid-60s to low 70s at the beaches, mid-60s to low 70s in metro LA and OC, mid-60s to low 70s in inland valleys, and high 50s to high 60s in the Inland Empire. We lead local, live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. I'm Brian Bruno.
When it comes to your identity and keeping it safe, the folks at LifeLock want to make sure that your information stays secure. So let's say during the pandemic, or even now, you're working overtime, you're saving your money, you're paying off your debt, and now some identity thief wants to steal your information. This is why LifeLock by Norton helps monitor your information and alerts you to potential identity threats. And if you do become a victim, a dedicated US-based specialist will be there to help fix it. Now, no one can prevent all identity theft or monitor every transaction, every business. But when identity thieves try to take what's yours, you don't have to take it lying down because there's LifeLock. Save up to 25% off your first year. Call 800-LIFELOCK or go to LifeLock.com, promo code HANDLE. That's LifeLock.com, promo code HANDLE, or call 800-LIFELOCK, promo code HANDLE. Once again, that's promo code HANDLE for 25% off at LifeLock.com.
Do you want out of your house for whatever reason? Maybe you're moving or downsizing, there are financial issues, maybe you inherited it.
Selling a home usually means hours of painting and cleaning and staging. But what if you could sell your home for a fair price without any of that hassle? The buyer never had to walk through your home. You could sell it without an appraisal, no commission, no fees.
What if you could get paid in cash and get it done fast, like in 10 days or less? This is exactly what directbuyers.com will do.
Directbuyers.com is a local family-owned business. They've been around since the mid-80s. We talked with the owners, Janet and Matt. Wonderful people. They care about their clients.
You don't want to go to a national call center. These are the people we trust. Do not sell your home until you talk to directbuyers.com. See what they can offer you. They will give you an honest, no-obligation offer. They can even get you $15,000 cash advance before closing to help with your move.
They're not going to lowball you. Go to directbuyers.com, directbuyers.com, 844-242-SELL. That's 844-242-SELL, directbuyers.com.
Upgrading.
KFI AM 640, live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app. You are home with Dean Sharp, the house whisperer. That's me. Hey, thanks for joining the program this morning. We've been talking about the mystery of contemporary homes. It's strange to think that homes being built today with today's standards are so mysterious and confusing for folks. But there are a lot of aspects to contemporary architecture that just seem a little odd. And most of us have been trained up in traditional homes, home style, and so it's a little foreign for us. So I've been taking some time to explain that. But now, as is our custom, it is time to go back to the phone. Let's find out what's going on with your home today. Rick, welcome home.
Hi, Dean. I just had a brand new shower installed in an upstairs bedroom. The shower floor is porcelain tile. And after just a couple weeks of usage, we're developing some dark-looking stains in the shower floor. So we're trying to figure out what's causing this.
Dark-looking stains. All right. Talk to me about the grout. What kind of grout do you have in between these tiles and the color of the grout as well?
Okay. The color of the grout is an off-white. It's probably sanded, I would expect it to be. The tile and the contractors came out and looked at it. They thought at first that it might have been moisture causing it, but they removed several of the tiles and it doesn't appear to be wet underneath. And it's just in some selected areas. Their first response was, well, we'll take the sections that are discolored out, replace it with new tile, and see if it continues to develop. Otherwise, the other option is to take the whole floor out of the shower. They've inspected the drain. They say the leak holes were clear. We even had the back wall of that shower open because we were doing another development in an adjoining shower. We were able to inspect behind the shower. There doesn't seem to be any moisture or leakage from there. So, what could cause that?
Yeah, you said this is a porcelain tile that you're using?
I'm pretty sure it's porcelain. Yes, it's not a man-made material. It's definitely a tile, it's not a stone.
Okay, so it's not a stone, so it's not the color of the thin set bleeding through from the backside. It's porcelain, so that's going to be irrelevant. And what do these stains look like? How dark are they?
They're pretty dark. I mean, at first we thought, you know, it looked like a surface stain, but it's not. And